ready. But someone had to have faith. Most of the time, it was not the sick person. It was the third person or the person ministry. Only about 25% of the time, it was the person that was sick that God commended faith. He didn't require it. God spared Lot because he remembered Abraham. All through the Old Testament and New Testament, it's usually a third person, somebody else's. Mark 5:22, and behold, there cometh one of the rulers of the synagogue, Jairus by name. And when he saw him, he fell at his feet and besought him great, saying, my little daughter lieth at the point of death. I pray thee, come and lay hands on her, that she may be healed, and she shall live. And Jesus went with him, and much people followed him and thronged him. Person of faith, Jairus. Jesus, the minister, person with faith. Woman with the issue of blood. We just read that. Healer, Jesus. Person with faith, the woman with the issue of blood, person healed with the issue of blood. The centurion, servant. Healer with Jesus, the servant asked, or the centurion asked about his servant. Third person again. Woman of Canaan's daughter, she got her daughter's healing. Widow unnamed son. Read that earlier today. Woman with a spirit of infirmity, and she was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath, and behold, it was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity 18 years, and was bowed together, and she could no wise lift up herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him, and said unto her, woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity. And he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God. And the ruler of the synagogue answered with indignation, because that Jesus had healed on the Sabbath day. And he said unto the people, there are 6 days in which men ought to work. In them therefore come and be healed, and not on the Sabbath day. And the Lord then answered him and said, thou hypocrite, doeth not each one of you on the Sabbath loose an ox or his ass from the stall, and lead him away to watering? And ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, who Satan hath bound, lo, these 18 years, be loosed from this bound on the Sabbath day? And when he had said these things, all of the adversaries were ashamed, and all of the people rejoiced for all the glorious things that were done by him. Jesus healed all. Matthew 4. And Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom. He didn't just preach salvation. He preached the gospel of the kingdom. There's a big difference. People are like, well, as soon as we get everybody saved, doesn't say that. Just read the words that are there. When you heal the sick, raise the dead, and cast out devils, when you get people healed, delivered, born again, you're putting one kingdom against another. The kingdom of light is pushing out the darkness. We're just like the light switches. We turn the lights on in here. Do I care where the darkness come from? Do I care how the darkness got in the building? Nope. I flip on the light, it just has to leave. That's all we are, is the switches that flip on. Hey, I carry the kingdom. Where I'm at, kingdom of darkness is going to have to flee. They can do it the easy way or the hard way, but they're going to go. Another scripture, Acts 10:38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Healing was as a sign, not a reward. You got to get this. You don't have to get something you already got. Mark 16. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. How many of you ever preached to animals? I do. I had some of the best trained horses and dogs. I got second in the nation 2 years in a row at the National Lamb Show. 4-H. I beat all the big boys. I prayed for it. I taught them about the kingdom. You're going to be the best sheep on earth. I think I actually had the best, but they didn't want the little kid beating all the big money people. You know, they just couldn't let you have first place. Well, you know, this is really good, but, you know, there's politics involved. He that believeth and baptized shall be saved. You know, I mean, vets were amazed. They give my animals no hope, and the next day they'd be up running around. I started messing with the vets before I messed with the doctors, I guess. And these signs shall follow. I've had a dog slay in the spirit twice, once for an hour and a half. And he's half border collie. You know how hard it is to get a border collie to sit still? He went, boom! It wasn't my idea. I'd gone down the road and he was in my semi and I seen the scripture go by here on all flesh. And I just went like this, touched the dog, and it lights out. His legs didn't even bow down. He's like a statue. He wakes up an hour and a half later like, where was I at? 50-some people got healed that year asking me what kind of dog that was. I said, that's a miracle dog. Best doctor in the world said his dad was sterile. Iowa State, we're right next. We know all the vets at Iowa State. They said, they got mad. There's no amount of money to get puppies out of him. He's a fourth generation from Scotland. He's half lab, half border collie. He looks the weirdest looking thing you ever seen. He looks like a mountain lion, marked like a border collie, long, skinny, looks like a pit bull head. The 1 and 2 year olds play with him, and he scares adults. He sneaks up on him, like the border collie, like the mountain lion. All he wants to do is have you throw a ball, and people think he's going to eat him alive. These signs shall follow that believe in my name. They will cast out devils. They will speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. If they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Ooh, this is going to wreck your theology. Pull your toes back so they don't get hurt. Now, this is the written word of God, and I suppose it's probably above everything else. We always taught if you preach the word and people hear it, faith comes by hearing, they'll get healed. That's not what it says. Luke 10:8-9. And into whatsoever city you enter and receive you, eat such things that are set before you, and heal the sick that are in there, and say unto them, the kingdom of God has come unto you. What do you do first? Heal or preach?
Heal.
What's
heal?
Oh, when's the last time you heard that? Right there it is. I'm just reading it. I ain't making it up. If the sick had to have faith to be healed, faith comes by hearing the word of God, they should have to preach first and then heal. But if healing is a sign of God's goodness that draws men to repentance, it is and is affected by authority and dominion over sickness and demons, then believers can heal first and then tell them how much they were healed, or tell them how they were healed. Remember the Indian reservation story? Man preached to him and said, hey, you want a new knee? Can I pray for you? He got a new knee before he could answer. Three knees, two backs, crippled arm grew out. Who wants to follow this God? They'll start bawling like babies. They were always taught they had to preach and preach. They preached for 2 years and got very little results. I healed first and they got 100%. See, I wonder which way works best. God's way or... I ain't telling you anything. I'm just reading the scripture and saying, yep, it's true. And we're giving you testimonies. The Indians were easier than most church people because they had no theology. I can make them kind of demons leave. It's the religious ones that always want to argue with you. Jesus heals against religious tradition. Imagine that. Matthew 12:9. And when he was departed thence, he went into their synagogue, and behold, there was a man which had a withered hand. And they asked him, saying, is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath days, that they might accuse him? And he said unto them, what man shall there be among you, that they shall have one sheep, and if it fall into a pit on the Sabbath day, will not lay hold of it, and lift it out? How much then is this man better than the sheep? Wherefore it is lawful to do well on the Sabbath days. And saith he unto the man, stretch forth thine hand. And he stretched it forth, and it was restored whole like the other. Then the Pharisees went out and held counsel against him how they might destroy him. Remember that story about the place I was telling you about? They tried to kick me out for healing their church. I thought it was God's church. If it ain't God's church, you better find out who really owns that building.
Amen.
Right.
You know, I couldn't figure out why God brought me back from the dead, and I'm finding out. They couldn't kick me out. They kept falling out. I just standing there. Wasn't my idea. And it was really hilarious. The more I think about it, the funnier it was. Like, here's this no-name truck driver walks in. They tell him he has no authority. They all fall out and get healed in all directions. Divine healing and the will of God. Healing is always God's will. What is God's will? You got to settle this. When you settle this, it will make your job so much easier. Make up your mind. Settle it once and forever. John 10:10. The thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and destroy. I am come that they might have life, and they might have it more abundantly.
Amen.
It's not abundant life. Drug dealers have abundant life. It's life abundantly. Big difference. One, you can have all the money in the world, have no peace, no health, no nothing, and go to hell. It's having life abundantly. If you just hear the testimony of the last couple of years of our marriage, like, wow, you couldn't buy this. I was pretty ticked off because I had millions of dollars stolen from me, embezzled, drug through the courts, made a public spectacle. But you know, my daughter gave birth a little over 5 years ago before her marriage. She called me. She thought she was dying. And I had to go back to my hometown area against all odds. I walked in, laid hands on her, in 5 minutes her blood was whole, the baby was normal. You'd think they would get it. They didn't quite get it yet, but they know when all hell goes loose who to call.
Amen.
My second daughter called me about 2 years ago, gonna have surgery on her jaw, well infected. I laid hands on it and she goes, it's gone. Went to the hospital, have surgery, and they said, what happened to you? It's normal. Yesterday, they did schedule you for emergency surgery. My sister, this one just blows me away. I'm going to do this quick and fast. When I was four, they said my mother could never have kids. I prayed for my mother, and I got a sister 5 years younger. Do the math. When she was two, I was seven. She had a thermometer. That's probably going to kill you or leave you brain dead. My mom curses God all night. I prayed all night. No side effects. If you drink any deadly thing, it will not harm you. I don't recommend eating mercury in glass. When she was five, she broke her arm at the growth center. My mother cursed me and wished I was never born. It was all my fault. It wasn't. But I took that condemnation most of my life. I prayed and it became her strong arm. At 45 years of age, she was a trick rider on horses. She could go around a horse. She's the only woman I know that had enough power to pull herself up. You don't think that's hard. Try to crawl around the underside of a horse and back up on the saddle.
Understand.
And do it. I don't care if you do it running. It's actually easier running.
Yeah.
It's harder to get the guts up to do it, but it's actually easier running than you can get a rhythm.
That's true.
But just try it anyway. We'll see how strong you are. Best doctor in the world said it would never work or grow again. Dad started this at a young age. I was 13. My dad was going to beat me to death for telling him my father was in heaven. My Bible said, call no man father. He froze. He was going to put a hammer through my skull. He already knocked me across the machine shed twice for telling the truth. He was mad because I wouldn't agree with his lie. Talk about being stubborn. Nobody listened to me, so I made a pipe bomb and blew it through my face. Bombs went through this face. Parts of the bomb went through my eyes. They took me to Wolf Eye Clinic after I came back from the dead, pulled parts out of both eyes. So I'd never seen it. When I was 18, trying to get help, my dad, he hit the starter when I told him not to. The car battery, parts and acid blew through both eyes a second time. Before morning, I could read the bottom of the eye chart. When I was 22, I come over the hill on a cab over freight liner. Road was blocked, nowhere to go. I had a choice of killing some people or hitting the park semi. Hit the park semi, I died a third time. Before morning, I walked out of the hospital. See, it ain't that I'm prideful, I'm confident. I don't have a theology, I have a life.
Amen.
I had mob guys hit on me. Several times they had cocked guns to my head. I told them they didn't have the authority. Get this. When I told my dad my father was in heaven, he froze. And I told the mob people they didn't have the authority, they froze. The problem was I didn't get it up here enough to say, hey, stop it, every time. You don't have the authority. You can't kick me out of here, because it ain't your church, it's God's church. You don't have the authority to do that. Authority is great faith.
Amen.
Knowing who you are in Christ. I don't have an anointed. I have the anointed one that lives in me. That's old covenant. That was done away with 2,000 years. Who wants two dead prophets? I'd rather have Jesus living in me.
Amen.
They're going to sell you two dead prophets and a partridge and a pear tree. I got Jesus. Why do I want your stupid stuff? Yeah, they wanted what we had. You know, all the prophets wanted what we had.
Yes.
They wanted to have Jesus living in them. They could only have the Holy Ghost on them. You got it living in you. You got the fullness living in you.
Right.
But you got to decide that you can do everything that I could do. You can do everything that they could do. How many would you go up against? Elijah, you went up against how many false prophets?
480.
Who won?
Elijah.
There was 4,000 people at trial. Who won? There was 2,000 in Kansas City. Who won? Couldn't get within 6 feet of me. We walked through the crowd and they parted like Benny Hinn. My buddy was shaking his boots. He said, I think Jesus is here. I said, I know he is. You don't think they're falling out because of me.
He's in here.
Yeah, but you gotta know how to let him out. Yep. Please don't come back. Oh, wait a minute. Before you were trying to tell me I couldn't. Now you're asking, please. So I took another guy down there and we went to the prophetic rooms because we thought they wanted prophetic people. They wanted some of their little prophets to prophesy. The prophets all fell out while they were prophesying over me and Terry and Jim. Please don't come back again. Divine healing and the will of God. You got to settle this. God's will must be that everyone might have life and have it more abundantly. 1 John 3:8. He that committeth sin is of the devil, for the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifest, that he might destroy the works of the devil. God's will must be that the works of the devil be destroyed. Who put sickness on people?
The devil.
You got these screwballs going around telling them God did it. We got a whole bunch in Des Moines, Iowa, trying to tell God's judging you. He put sickness on you. Are you nuts?
Yeah, I've heard that about.
Please don't tell anybody you're a preacher or a believer. Tell them you're somebody else. Like, come on.
Might as well be an atheist if you ain't talking to God.
Acts 10:30, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. What about doing good and healing all that were present? God had to heal his own diseases. Can think about it. No wonder the Christians have such a hard time getting faith or knowing what's supposed to be right. We've heard all this garbage and threw it in one pot. God's will must be that if it is with someone that they should be anointed with the Holy Ghost and with power, and they should go about doing good and healing all that are oppressed of the devil. Beloved, I wish above all things that they may prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. God's will must be that we prosper and be in health, as our soul prospereth. Before you can be in health, you must have to be healed. After this manner, therefore, pray you, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. God's will must be that his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. It's getting better. It's going to get some more ouches, though. James 1:22. Be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves.
There you are, right there.
Yeah, here's some really deep theology. Now, hang on. If you ain't doing it, you ain't doing it.
Deceiving yourself.
Either you're doing it or you ain't doing it. If you ain't doing it, start doing it. I overcame it. I couldn't hardly talk to people. I forced myself every day to go find somebody that needed healing. And I did some really weird stuff. I just grabbed them, chained them, and wouldn't let go until the power of God hit them. There is no qualification in which word we are to be doers of and which word we are to ignore. It's not a buffet. The New Testament is not a buffet. You don't get to pick and choose. Well, I like that, but I really don't like that part. Well, I'll just do the part that I like and
it's a whole.
What is God's will? This one just kind of made me laugh. One of them, which was a lawyer, asked him a question, tempted him and said, I and my fellow lawyers, I can tell you where a whole bunch of crooked ones are. Master, which is the great commandment? Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second one like it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Of these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Therefore, all things whatsoever you want men to do unto you, do even so unto them, for this is the law and the prophets. If you are sick and someone had the power of God in their life to heal you, would you want them to come to you and minister healing?
Right now.
Anyone who will answer honestly would have to say they would. If your answer is in your answer is a commission to the healing ministry. Now, I want to die. Just bring me chicken soup. That's what most of the church people have been taught. Well, you know, we just took them to hospice and helped them die. Would Jesus do that?
No.
If you'd want somebody to heal you, it's your requirement that you go heal the other people. You know, and I didn't love myself most of my life. I couldn't even look at me in the mirror. It wasn't until the last decade that I could even talk to people. I heard that tape, you're worthless, you're no good, you're not going to amount to nothing, you'll never be any good, you just junk garbage, you know. And it was way worse than some of the words I even use in church. I forced myself to look in the mirror and tell me who God said I was. I got a list of who I am in Christ. I forced myself every day. I didn't love me, but I know that if Jesus was here, they'd get that person set free. And that's how I got me out of that ditch. There was nobody to help me out of the ditch. They always wanted to kick me down. The church wanted to shoot their wounded.
Yeah, they're popping.
Absolutely.
Our job is to lift them out. He said two by two, so one fell, the other could lift him. What? Kick him when he's down?
Church, no.
Hey, brother, don't do that anymore. That's the worst thing happen. Don't go play in that toilet anymore. Mm-hmm. Stop it. Not that you don't love them, you don't want them to go get in the same thing again.
Right.
There's demons attached to most of this false teaching. What is divine healing? Here's some more ouches. Divine healing is not directing the doctor's hands. If Jesus was here, would he tell you to go to the doctor or would he say, I can help you? I made a whole bunch of doctors and nurses mad at a meeting a while back. Did you tell me Jesus said I can't help you go see Luke the doctor? Well, no. I said, well, all I'm doing is telling you what Jesus would say. Well, you know, God created doctors. Oh, really? So Jesus said I can't help you, so I'm going to create doctors to help you. Did Jesus say that, or would he say that? Could he say that? You got to decide. I've already made up my mind.
No, you did not.
So far, every doctor's lied to me. They said I was dead, blind, and crippled, never walk again, never see again, never be able to move again. Yeah, Jesus never lied to me, but every doctor has.
And most lawyers.
No, all lawyers have. Divine healing is not connected to exercise, diet, or nutrition. If you don't eat curry, we do not eat curry. Curry has never ate a vegetable in his life, and he's 54 years old, with the same age. He's been sick in 25 plus years. He kills sick ones. I'm not telling you to do that, by your faith be it done unto you. Do we get attacked once in a while? Yeah, but we don't stop. Are we perfect? No, but we don't back down. Divine healing is not immortality. And according to the Bible, when you get your work done, you just lay down and go to sleep. Nowhere in the Bible does it say, hey, when you get most of your work done, you're going to get cancer and die. You're going to get AIDS and die. You're going to get sickness and die. Because when you get your years fulfilled, and you get your job done, you lay hands on the next generation and say, I'm going home. Kenneth Hagin was a pretty good example of that. He preached his last sermon. Told everybody it was his last sermon. He told them, when I'm done here, I'm going to go to home. Sat down and went home. Divine healing is not immunity, although immunity is promised to Christians. Divine healing is the power of God working within a person's body to remove sickness and disease and to repair the part of the human body that has been affected by sickness, disease, or demonic influence. Everyone Jesus healed later died. If a person continues doing what they did to get sick the first time, the sickness may come back on them. What about the sovereignty of God? Divine healing does not affect or interfere with the sovereignty of God. Actually, it enhances, establishes it. The thief, Satan, comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Jesus came to give life and that more abundantly. John 10:10. When the enemy, the thief, Satan, tries to come to steal, kill, and destroy, we act as Jesus' ambassador to stop the thief, accomplish his goal by bringing the abundant life that Christ came to provide. This is the body of Christ enforcing God's sovereignty, just as a policeman enforcing the city's sovereignty by enforces. Just as a policeman enforces the city's sovereignty by enforces that the city's law. Definition of sovereignty. Supreme power or authority. Number two, the authority of a state to govern itself or another state. Three, one holding supreme independent authority over a region or state. Four, one that does not have to answer to another in the governing of affairs. See, when you got born again, you got the police badge. When you got filled with the Holy Ghost, you got the gun and the bullets. Two separate things. One is authority, one is ability. The devil has ability, but no authority. That's why he's a thief and a robber. Does a thief and a robber need permission?
No.
He's a thief and a robber. Does a bank robber need permission to rob the bank?
No.
He did it illegally.
Right.
And you got people that, you know, while I open the door and let the thief in, here's some deep ones. We'll hit them again. All authority was given to Jesus on heaven and earth, correct?
Mm-hmm.
How much authority do you have? You said Jesus had it all.
He gave it to us when he left.
He gave us his authority, not our authority.
There's
a big difference. Since he has all authority and you only can use it, can you give any authority to the devil?
No.
That's the point I'm making. Either he has it all or you do. Make up your mind. What's the word say? The word said he has it all in heaven and earth. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay. So even if you wanted to give the authority to the devil to do something to you, you don't have the ability. Not yours to give away. That wrecks all that false teaching and all them book writers. Well, you gave the devil permission. You don't have the ability to do that. Okay, if a thief breaks into your house, is he a thief? If the policeman comes, is he going to ask how the thief got in, or is he going to arrest him and find out later?
Arrest and find out later.
That's your job. What if you leave the door open?
He's still a trespasser.
Thank you. It doesn't matter. He's still a thief and a robber, and he's illegal. It doesn't matter. You might be stupid, but he's still a thief and a robber. We don't care. Well, we've done some dumb things. I have. I've done, I probably beat about every one of you doing some stupid thing. Pretty good ones. If you know some of the stories, and you can ask some of my friends that I brought with them, I pushed the limit on most things. You know, Moses was a murderer. He wrote the law against it. Well, why did God pick him? Because he usually picked the least likely to do the job. King David should have been stoned to death several times, and God said, there's a man after my own heart. Why would God pick somebody like that? Why did God say there was a man after my own heart?
Takes the foolish things to confound the wise.
Nope, what's the word saying? Don't guess. Because David did one thing nobody else did.
Obey.
No matter what, he'll do anything that I ask him to do. He messes up the rest of the time, but there's one thing that I love about David. He will do anything that I ask him to do. My grandmother made me name David after that. And kind of fit the bill. God says, go do that. And all the religious people tell me I can't, but God already told me I could, so he's right and they're wrong. I got kicked out of over 100 churches, some big world ones. I named a couple of them. Who gives you the right to do that? Jesus. Who sent me? Jesus. I was scared to death the first few times, but after they go flying through the air, it's okay, God. And behold, there came a leper and worshiped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately the leprosy was cleansed. King James, this is the NIV. A man with leprosy came and knelt before him and said, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Jesus reached out his hand and touched him. I am willing, he said, be clean. Immediately he was cured. All four translations say the same. Five. It's always his will. I will. It's always my will. Just as the English language has two different meanings of the word will, so does the language. We would say, I will do that. We will do something even if we do not want to do it. We would say, I will do that. When we decide we're going to do something that we earnestly desire to do, we see the same pattern in what Jesus said in Matthew 8, 2 and 3. I will. There's the Strong's of I will. Don't try to take away from the Word of God or add to it. Total healing for the total person. Healing through the redemption. Psalm 103 said, at best, sin and sickness are two fruits from the same tree. Sin and sickness are always grouped together. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits, who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemed thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercy, who satisfies thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. Note verse 6 above. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. Our judicial system was originally based on the Mosaic law system of law. Even the terminology used in our courts are similar to the Elizabethan English of the King James Version. When a person needs a lawyer to represent them is because they need someone that knows when and how to make motions that will be accepted by the court. God executes judgment for the oppressed. God is not the oppressor. Acts 10:38 tells us who the oppressor is. It is the devil. God, as the great judge of heaven and earth, has decreed freedom for all that are oppressed. Jesus went about doing good and healing, setting free all that the devil held in bondage through the oppression of sin and sickness. It's going to be hard reading some of these other books. We have no problem telling an unsaved person that Jesus died for them and fully paid the penalty for their sins, thus providing their salvation over 2,000 years ago. Then he will no wise reject them if they accept his sacrifice. There is no question as to whether or not they can be saved. Yet the exact wording is used for healing of their physical sickness and disease as it is used for the healing of their spiritual sickness, sin. The Greek word used, and even the very tenses of the word used, are exactly the same. The tense is even the strongest tense in the Greek language. Jesus purchased man's health and healing just as he purchased our salvation from sin. When Jesus purchased our spiritual redemption, he also purchased our healing because the sickness and disease was the result of the sin. Providing one, salvation from sin, he provided the other, healing from sickness. In reality, he could not have done the first without doing the second, as the second symptom was the result of the first cause. The very word salvation in Hebrew and Greek means the same thing. Absolute deliverance from all harm and lack. Sin came into the world by man, Adam's sin. Genesis 3:1-6. Romans 5:12. Therefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death upon all men, for all have sinned. Romans 5:17. For by one man's offense death resigned by one, much more they which received abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ. Healing is again connected to the atonement in Scripture concerning the Lord's Supper and Communion. Do you know how some believers are supposed to get healed? Laying hands is really for the unbelievers. Speaking in tongues is really for the unbelievers. How are believers scripturally supposed to get healed? Communion, when you take this bread, remember that I healed you. This is the bread. The bread is the healing. Oscar, feet got healed, the lady got new lungs. We had homemade bread and lemonade. Take this, but you got to believe it's going to become bone of your bone, flesh of your flesh. What happened when they walked out of Egypt? First Passover, right? The blood saved their life, correct? What did they do with the rest of the lamb? It became bone of their bone, flesh of their flesh, and there was not one sick or feeble among them. They're arguing if there was 2 to 3 million somewhere in that neighborhood, there was not one sick or feeble among them. Now we live under a better covenant with better promises. So why do we have sick believers? It's an oxymoron. We're not believing. We're thinking, we're analyzing, we're making excuses. When they took the meat and ate it, became bone of their bone. The first time I made this work, I used a can of Coke and a Snicker bar. I gave the guy half of my Snicker bar, he ate it, drank the Coke, and instantly got healed. I have never used special anything. The closest I ever got when I would run around, once in a while I'd buy olive oil. Otherwise, I played jokes on people. I went to Dollar Tree and got scented oil and told people it was special oil, and they all got healed. Where'd you get that? Here, I'll just give you some. They believed it was special and they got results. Oh, that's so special. I said, yeah, I got from really special people. Dollar Tree, the bottle for a dollar.
Yep.
I didn't spend some $100 going to Holy Land and getting some special olive oil. Usually I buy the stuff that's only 10%. The extra virgin means it's only 10%. The rest is soybean oil. Truth will set you free. So many people don't want to find truth. Healing in the communion. Become bone of your bone. We've had recreative miracles. I don't care if it's a crack. What happened with it? Come here. One or both of you, yeah. Did I demonstrate this a couple weeks ago?
Which one? I'm sorry.
The little fishy crackers.
Yes, you did.
Come here.
Okay.
Tell them what happened when you put the little fish crackers in your hand. So I said, just get something to eat. Some lady brought us some little crackers. But they, oh, they're fish.
Yeah.
Tell them what happened.
Well, it started to felt the power of God in it.
Before you put it in your mouth, I'd drop it in your hand. They're getting wrecked.
Yeah. And then he gave us the cup, and I was going all over the place.
So was everybody else.
So was everybody. Was.
Hey, go watch the video. I think it was on, I think we used, yeah, we used straightened it.
Yeah, I believe so.
It was the believing. When you become bone of your bone.
Right.
It's always the believing. It says only believe, and we had about 20 more things to that.
Yeah.
If I told you to get two words and you got 22, it says only believe. So only believe, but it's because of what Jesus did. It was because of what he did. It wasn't anything you did. It's the only the believing part. Believing, not thinking. This is our problem. This is our solution. It gets so simple. Okay, when they were evening come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils, and he cast out the spiritually word, and he healed all that were sick, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. Notice that the fulfillment of Isaiah 53, everyone had to be healed, which was a reference to the future of total fulfillment by Jesus' scourging and death. See where it said he had to heal them all or he couldn't be the Christ? I didn't make this up. I was amazed. It was, wow, this is so simple. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. Don't try to make the blood do something the beating was. If he never went to the cross, you would have had all your healing paid for at the whipping post. One atonement, two separate things. He was beat for all your physical healing. I've seen people, well, I'm praying the blood of Jesus over you to be healed. Well, stop it. It's by his stripes you were healed.
Amen.
He was beaten for your physical healing. The blood is the sin. Two separate things, one package deal. But if you believe it's the blood that's going to heal you, you're wrong. The blood forgives your sins. Just like the angel of death, that's what Jesus was doing. He was the last Passover lamb.
Amen.
There wasn't going to be another one. From that point forward, you had to believe that he did it.
Yes.
See, Isaiah said, by his stripes you are healed. They had to have faith that it was going to happen. After the will is done, signed, sealed, delivered, it's past tense. Second Peter says you were already healed. You don't have to get it already happened. It's like writing a check to an unlimited bank account. How much faith does it take if you had $100 million in your bank account to write a $100 check? It takes a lot of faith if you only got $10 in your account. See the difference? One, it's already all in your account already.
Right.
Yeah. See, 2 Peter, past tense. So you got to do everything through the cross. Most of what Jesus said, well, the letters are in red. Well, most of the time Jesus was telling a Jew how to be a Jew. He couldn't lie to them. You got to take it, was Jesus talking to believers or Jews? Two different covenants. Don't mix them. That's where people get double-minded. Who was talking to who? What time frame was it? Sons of God act different than servants. The servant's always bigger. God, please, God, please. He said, I already did. You do it. Let's take a break. Come back a little bit after 4. We'll prove that this is physical healing. We made some ministers mad a couple nights ago. Oh, just spiritual healing. Well, you got to negate all these scriptures that said it was talking about physical.